Good morning, Morobe Elementary. My name is Cindy, and I am your teacher Maggie's sister. And today it's doing something really fun at my house, so let me show you. Look at this. It's snowing today. We're having a beautiful snowstorm, and I thought that we might read a book together about the snow. So I got my sled and my puppy. Come here, Jack. Come here, Jack. There we go. And Jack and I are going to read you a story. Come on, Jack, let's go. I'm going to sit right here on the sled. And let's set up the camera. And I have a story about the snow. I also have my mittens. I used to have white mittens, but I lost them. So Jack and I are going to read you the story. The story I'm going to read is called The Mitten. This story is a Ukrainian folktale by Jan Brett. Look closely at the picture of the mitten with a little boy in it here. What is he doing? This is even before the story starts. What is he doing? See his grandma? Once there was a boy named Nicky who wanted his new mittens that would be made white as the snow. See what his grandma's doing? At first, his grandma Baba did not want to make him white mittens. She said, "If you drop one in the snow, you'll never find it." But Nicky wanted mittens, white mittens, and finally Baba made them. After she finished, she said, "When you come home, first I will look to see if you are safe and sound, and then I will look to see your snow-white mittens." So off Nicky went, and it wasn't long before one of his new mittens fell in the snow and was left behind. Maybe that's what happened to my white mittens. Look what's coming. And a mole, tired from tunneling along, discovered the mitten and burrowed inside it. He climbed inside. It was cozy and warm and just the right size, so he decided to stay. See? Now what's coming? A snowshoe rabbit came hopping by. He stopped for a moment to admire his winter coat. It was then that he saw the mitten and he wiggled in feet first. The mole didn't think there was room for both of them, but when he saw the rabbit's big kickers, he moved over. See, look at that. So now the mole and the rabbit are in the mitten. What's coming next? Next, a hedgehog came snuffling along. Having spent the day looking under wet leaves for things to eat, he decided to move into the mitten and warm himself. The mole and the rabbit were bumped and jostled, but not being ones to argue that, and with someone covered with prickles, they made room for him. There they are. What's coming next? As soon as the hedgehog disappeared into the mitten, a big owl, attracted by the commotion, swooped down. When he decided to move in also, the mole, the rabbit, and the hedgehog grumbled, but when they saw the owl's glinty talons, they quickly let him in. Boy, they don't fit very well, do they? What's coming next? Come, Jack! Come, Jack! Up through the snow appeared a badger. He eyed the mitten and began to climb in. The mole, the rabbit, and the hedgehog and the owl were not pleased, but there was no room left. But when they saw his diggers, they gave him the thumb. Oh, it's getting pretty tight in that mitten. And what's coming next? Ooh. It started snowing, but the animals were snug in the mitten. A waft of warm steam rose in the air, and a fox trotted by to stop to investigate. Just the sight of the cozy mitten made him feel drowsy. The fox poked his muzzle in. When the mole, the rabbit, the hedgehog, the owl, and the badger saw his shiny teeth, they gave the fox lots of room. And what's coming next? A great bear lumbered by. He spied the mitten all plumped up, and not being one to be left out in the cold, he began to nose his way in. The animals were packed in as tightly as could be, but what animal would argue with a bear? The mitten swelled and stretched. It was pulled and bulged so many times its size, but Baba's good knitting held fast. Ooh, and what is coming next? Along came a meadow mouse, no bigger than an acorn. She wriggled into the one space left and made herself comfortable on top of the great bear's nose. Oh, I think Nicky's discovered that he's missing his mitten. Oh no! The bear, tickled by the mouse's whiskers, gave an enormous sneeze. Achoo! The force of the sneeze shot the mitten up into the sky and scattered the animals in all directions. On his way home, Nicky saw a white shape in the distance. It was the lost mitten silhouetted against the blue sky. And he caught his mitten. As he ran to catch his snow-white mitten, he saw Baba's face in the window. First, she looked to see if he was safe and sound, and then she saw that he still had his white mittens. The end. So, I don't have white mittens anymore. Now I have black mittens. Come, Jack. Here, Jack. Jack and I had a good time reading you a story. So I hope you have a good snow day. Bye-bye.